Welcome back guys, this is Vishu from SavageCamp and in this video, we are going to discuss the networking skills that you require to become an infrastructure engineer. So if you are new to this channel, I'm putting together a set of videos that will help you become a better infrastructure engineer. I also have an introduction to this role and the Linux skills that you require for this role already in this playlist. And in this video, we will discuss the networking skills that you will require for this role. So without any further delay, let's get into the role and what you need from the networking perspective to succeed in this role. So the first part of networking that you should know if you're going to apply for this role is the networking fundamentals. Now, what does networking fundamentals consist of? So the bare components of any networks are its network switch and network routers. There's also RJ45 cables, there's optical fiber cables, there's SFPs. So when it comes to all of these parts, you should have a basic understanding of what these parts are in a network and what are their responsibilities and functions. When would you use a network switch and when would you use a network router? You should know the difference between these two. What are VLANs? How do routing works in a router? How does routing works in a switch? How does the packet get out of the network through a default gateway? And how does the request that is made out of network comes in through one IP address and goes into like hundreds of other IP addresses, which is called as NAT, which is network address translation. All of these things are the fundamental blocks of networking. And I'm going to put together a cheat sheet for you guys. So you have a list of things that you can look at and know where you stand. So the first part is the basics, and in the next part, we'll go over the details of these components and which ones should you focus on. One of the main components of this role is troubleshooting. And when it comes to troubleshooting, you don't know where the problem is and you are expected to find out the problem and give it to the engineers to resolve it. Or you can resolve it if you have the appropriate permissions. So how do you find where the problem is? Well, you need to know how routing works because all the networks route traffics. That's the purpose of a network, to connect two different components of an infrastructure via a network. So one network is always going to be sending traffic to the other one and the other one is going to receive and send traffic back. So whenever there's a problem, you should be able to understand where the problem is and why it is occurring. So it could be traders complaining that they're not seeing proper data coming through from the exchanges, and then you find out there's a bad port in the switch which is dropping all the packets, and that's why they are not able to receive good data. So that is just an example that I made up, but you should be able to troubleshoot, and to troubleshoot you need to know how routing works. So you have to understand the routing protocols, which would be BGP, OSPF, RIP, RIP version 2, which is barely used, but it is good to know. But all of these protocols, it's very important for you to understand how these protocols work, the commands that you should use to troubleshoot whenever a routing issue occurs, and how to resolve it. Like, would you use a backup network, or would you reroute it through some other network, or what are the steps that you can take to troubleshoot this? So this is one of the most important part of troubleshooting, is understanding routing and where the problem lies. So we have covered in this video that you need to know the fundamentals of networking. You need to know the routing protocols, how routing works, and the routing commands that you need to troubleshoot any routing issues in the network. Well, there are smaller things that if you know can make your life easier in this role. Some of these things are understanding how IP addresses and subnets work, because you might be getting a lot of requests to whitelist IPs and you need to know which subnet they live in to correctly whitelist, because if someone wants a /32 whitelisted, which means that only one IP needs to be whitelisted, and if you do like /30 or /29, you are adding like 4 or 8 IP addresses to the network that shouldn't be in. So you need to understand IP addresses and subnet mask. You also have to understand how switch ports work, the different types of cables that go into the switch port. It could be a fiber optic cable, it could be an RJ45 cable. You also can have SFPs, which can cause some issues. So there would be data center issues where you would have to go and replace the cables because the port is bad. The port could be bad because it is dropping the packet, or there are errors on the cable because the cable is bad. So your role would be to go into the switch, find out which port is bad, and see if the issue is with the SFP or if the issue is with the cable. So that is also one of the responsibilities. The other things that you would get is basically to configure VLANs, which you should know. VLANs are very fundamental part of any networking or any switch. So configuring VLANs, adding new routes, static routes or dynamic routes. You will also be asked to bounce ports or configure ports, which is not a big deal. It would take you a day to understand all of these. So it's on low priority. It's like daily tasks that you can learn anytime. So these are the other things that you need to know when it comes to networking. And I think that is it for this section. So now let's get into the last section for the networking skills you need to know for this infrastructure engineer role. Now this is kind of an intermediate to advanced level. This will give you a lot of advantage over other people going for this role. You have to understand what the anycast, multicast or broadcast is and how to configure them. Now you might be getting some multicast issues. This is more common in trading firms because they use multicast. And if there are multicast issues, it's going to be a big production issue because it's usually with exchanges where exchanges give their rates out. If you're on the wrong channel or subscriber mode, then it would cause a lot of issues. Usually this sits with the networking team. You are supposed to understand what the issue is and just pass it on to the networking team because they have extra privileges to change the routes or change the multicast data groups. But it would be very helpful if you have a good understanding of how these things work, and whenever someone tells you that we are not receiving any data on this channel, it's very helpful if you can just troubleshoot the bare minimum and give the networking team a brief summary of all the commands that you ran and if you think it's an issue on our end or it's an issue on the exchange. So this is not a requirement, but it's always going to put you further ahead than others if you know how to troubleshoot multicast issues. And I think that's it for this video. So in the last section, I will summarize whatever we talked about in this video, and I will also put together a cheat sheet for you guys. So now we are at the last section of this video, which is a basic recap of everything that we have covered for this role. So when it comes to networking, the first thing you need to know is the fundamentals, which is what is a switch, what is a router, what are IP addresses and subnets, how a switch works, how a router works, what is the difference between a switch and a router, when should you use a layer 2 versus layer 3 switch, when should you use a router versus a switch, what are VLANs. All of these are very basic knowledge when it comes to networking, and you should be well versed with all of these. Now let's come to the second part, which is the routing protocols. Now this is going to be very important because you are supposed to troubleshoot any issues that come on infrastructure, and a lot of these issues are related to routing. So you need to have a basic understanding of routing protocols, how these routing protocols work, the routing commands that you can use on Cisco or Nexus iOS to troubleshoot any issues with regards to routing, and where to look for whenever there's an issue. Is it an issue on our end? Is it an issue on their end? So that's the second part that you need to know. The third part is the other basic things, which would be like how to bounce a port, how to configure VLANs, how to configure a switch port, how to check where the problem is. You can also know TCP dump or the other trace route, like commands like these, which would make your life easier when it comes to this particular role. So that's the third part. And the last part, which is kind of an intermediate to advanced level, is when you are able to understand how anycast, broadcast and multicast works. One thing that will also help you is understanding MAC address tables and how IP/ARP works or RARP works, and if someone gives you an IP address, how to trace it back to the switch port that it is connected to. So these are like small things that you will have to do every day, and it's not high priority, but it's a time saver if you know all of these things. To find the running config of the port, to find the running config of the switch, how to write into the running config, how to save it so whenever the switch restarts, you don't lose all the changes. All of these are the stuff that you, if you know, it would make your life easier. but you can always look this up whenever any ticket or an issue arises. The last part is kind of an intermediate to advanced level thing. This comes with Anycast, Broadcast and Multicast. Whenever there's an issue with Multicast, it's always helpful if you are able to find out what the issue is. Is the issue on our end or is the issue with the exchange? Did we subscribe to the wrong channel? Is that IP address that we subscribe to no longer active? Is that IP address being blocked by firewall? It's always good if you know what is going on and you are able to troubleshoot and relay a good summary of whatever you troubleshooted to the network team. This will always put you in good eyes and you will always get complimented because you're making everyone's life easier by taking on the troubleshooting part. So all the network engineers have to do is resolve the problem. They don't have to spend time troubleshooting it because you already did it. So I think that is it for this video, guys. And in the next video, I will cover the basic knowledge that you need to know when it comes to like storage or Windows. So that's it for this video, guys. And I will see you guys in the next video.